Julia Hartley Brewer at breakfast on Talk Radio.
Good morning to you. This is Talk Radio Breakfast with me, Julia Hartley Brewer. I think we've got Dr. Alan Mendoza back, Executive Director of the Henry Jackson Society, talking about that Channel 4 documentary alleging that scientists created a false narrative about whether or not the COVID virus had leaked from a Wuhan lab. This was on last night. And again, there's always been talk that actually, you know, there was a big cover up in China about whether this virus had been leaked from a lab or not. But also the claim in this documentary is that leading scientists actually in the West, including Sir Jeremy Farrar, who's president of the Wellcome Trust and one of the senior advisors to the government on COVID, had actually basically created a false narrative about this and dismissed critics and anyone claiming there might have been a leak as conspiracy theorists and really sort of stopped any investigations into this. What do you make of that?
Well, Julia, it sort of tallies with what I think we know is increasing the case, that we had scientists in the West who, and the documentary makes this quite clear, were acting without science to make their political assessments. Whatever the reason for why they were saying that conspiracy theories were wrong, it wasn't backed by the science. And that's the most damaging thing, I think, for all. These are eminent scientists. They should have known better. They know that to make a scientific assessment requires scientific evidence, requires hypothesis testing and other things. And they rushed out and made a statement that wasn't backed by any evidence. And worse for them, the conspiracy that's coming out continues to point to the lab leak, you know, theory being a great possibility at the moment. And I think we're all waiting now for the official US report to land on Joe Biden's desk. Next week, I think it's supposed to be out, to determine, you know, how seriously the US is taking this.
Well, that's it. And we know that Joe Biden admitted, you know, this was something they were looking at. And Donald Trump had always claimed that was the evidence that he had seen. And I guess because it was Donald Trump, everyone said, oh, he's a mad conspiracy theorist. It can't possibly be true. But it was always a very likely possibility, given that the lab that looks into these sort of bat viruses is in Wuhan. And the place where they had originally come from was 400 miles away. I mean, it was not by any stretch of the imagination unlikely that it was a leak. And also the disappearance of various scientists who raised concerns early on in China were also added to the fears that something was going on. I understand also there's been some genomic sequencing done and just showing that it's just incredibly unlikely that this virus could actually have come about naturally because of, I mean, I'm not a scientist, but scientific experts who are have said that, you know, that there are some very unlikely evidence that it could be have just come about naturally. Well, in terms of the implications of this, a lot of people would say, doesn't, you know, either way, we ended up with a worldwide pandemic and millions dead and massive hit to our economy and damage to our civil liberties and the like. But others would say, well, actually, there is a significance to this. What is the significance? Why does it matter how that virus got spread around the world?
Well, it matters, Julia, because if it is basically China's meddling with science that has led to this virus being manipulated from a bat virus into something that's infected humans, by the way, you're quite right to point that out. The documentary shows that this virus came out fully formed, basically, highly unusual in the virus world in the way it was able to infect humans so easily. Normally, a virus mutates, it has to develop to do that. This virus, from day one, was highly contagious. And the reason sort of posited for that in the documentary is that it actually was a relative of a bat virus that had infected workers in China back in 2013, and they'd been working on it ever since to try and figure out, you know, how viruses work, what would be the results of a pandemic, and it escaped, basically. The point of this is, much like the Chernobyl incident in the old Soviet Union, there's been massive negligence on the part of the Chinese authorities here, and as a result, they owe us compensation for what they have wreaked on this world. Yep. Everyone who has lost money, everyone who's lost a loved one to this virus, should be pointing the finger of blame right now to China and saying, we want to see the evidence for what happened in that lab, because we don't think you're innocent.
Absolutely. I don't understand why there isn't this widespread demand for reparations. It's extraordinary. Thank you so much indeed. Glad we got you back on the line, Dr. Alan Mendoza from the Henry Jackson Society.